West 2 News continues.
Law enforcement in Daytona Beach say that they had relatively few issues at the recent Biketoberfest event that drew more than 100,000 motorcycle enthusiasts.
But they have different concerns about an unsanctioned event called Trucktoberfest driven by social media. As West 2's Claire Metz reports, it's planned for this weekend and law enforcement will be out in force to resolve any problems.
If you're going to come here and you're going to do burnouts and act like the fool and destroy our quality of life, you're not going to like the way we react.
Word of an unsanctioned, unsponsored truck event this weekend has Eastside police agencies and the county sheriff working together to patrol it. In June, a truck meet led to some chaotic hours as visitors in jacked up trucks created gridlock on A1A, damaged property, tore up the beach. Residents complained loudly, and Sheriff Mike Chitwood is more than annoyed that another truck event, born on social media, is reportedly heading this way.
They caused tremendous grief. They cost taxpayers money. Nobody wants it. The business community doesn't want it. The government doesn't want it, and the neighborhoods don't want it.
I think our residents deserve better.
State Representative Tom Leake says pop-up events have become so disruptive. He and Senator Tom Wright plan to introduce a bill that would allow cities to create special event zones. For the duration of the event, penalties for infractions could be doubled. Vehicles could more easily be impounded.
If we give the local jurisdictions the ability to create these special event zones, then they'll better be able to control the event.
Meantime, police and deputies will make themselves seen and heard to deter potential trouble.
There's extra deputies, extra police officers, there's tow trucks, there's a unified command put into place, and there's going to be a zero tolerance.
Local law enforcement is taking Trucktoberfest so seriously, they're actually activating the jail in Daytona Beach Shores to be used as a holding facility. They're hoping they won't need it, but they want to be prepared. In Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.